Millions of years ago, a meteorite made of vibranium, the strongest substance in the universe, struck the continent of Africa, affecting the plant life around it. And when the time of men came, five tribes settled on it and called it Wakanda. The tribes lived in constant war with each other until a warrior shaman received a vision from the panther goddess Bust, who led him to the heart-shaped herb, a plant that granted him superhuman strength, speed, and instincts. The warrior became king and the first Black Panther, the protector of Wakanda. Four tribes agreed to live under the king's rule, but the Jabari tribe isolated themselves in the mountains. The Wakandans used vibranium to develop technology more advanced than any other nation. But as Wakanda thrived, the world around it descended further into chaos. To keep vibranium safe, the Wakandans vowed to hide in plain sight, keeping the truth of their power from the outside world.
And we still hide, Baba?
Yes.
Why?
We interrupt this program to bring you a special report.
This is Cheapseat Reviews.
Hello, and thank you for listening to Cheapseat Reviews, the podcast that explores the Hollywood film industry for the greater good.
The greater good.
Okay, sure. Why not? This is episode something. I don't have my 229, and tonight we're talking about
Wakanda,
the Black Panther. I am Sean Allred, and joining me tonight is Andrew Wakanda Forever Jimison.
I will spare you my Wakandan accent for fear of it sounding like a German, like Sam.
That's good. That's probably good. That's
yeah.
Probably good. Probably good. And Sam, if you speak one more word, I will feed you to my children, Vector.
But I won't not talk in an accent for Wakanda, because I will stomp you down with one of my raging war rhinoceroses.
Don't know.
That was a trip around the world, folks.
I don't know what that was. Yeah, it's like you just ran circles through Epcot. Like, I don't know what that was. Like, you started off as like a little bit of Black Panther and then ended up somewhere next to...
We definitely visited England.
Yes.
Yeah.
That was a while.
It was almost as if... it was almost as if Catherine Zeta...
Are world travelers.
Okay, Nigel.
Right. Yeah, you sound like Nigel from Jumanji. Welcome to Jumanji. I am your guide, Nigel. It is a pleasure to meet you. We watched that this weekend again. It's such a fun movie. Okay. Well, yeah, so this is Black Panther. The super successful, highly anticipated, extremely lucrative movie from the MCU.
What isn't lately?
Well, that's true. It's that noise, right? Seriously, it's weird noises in my house. But in case you're actually curious as to what is Black Panther and just haven't been around this year, because again, this movie's not yet a year old. For some reason, because we've had so much happen in the MCU, it feels like the movie is 2 years old. It came out in February of this year, of 2018. So, Andrew, just kind of remind us, what is, in fact, Black Panther? Andrew? Did you fall asleep on us?
Oh, he's frozen.
Yeah, he's totally frozen. Yeah,
I'm looking at the side of his head.
Yeah, I'm looking at his ear hole. That's weird.
Yeah, that's very strange. I'm still here, though.
Yeah, I'm glad.
No, you're not.
Seriously, did we lose Andrew?
I think he probably froze, yeah. So do you think Black Panther would have been released in February if they knew how successful it was going
to
be?
Yes, I think that was intention. Well, you needed it to be a February release because you had the lead up.
Oh, that's right.
You needed Infinity War to be your big summer release, your tentpole. Okay, we got Andrew back. No worries. Everything's fine. We're fine here. We're all fine. How are you?
Yes.
Hey, Declan. What are you doing? We're never going to get this show going. All right, hold on.
I just want to watch some football.
Pause the show again. Okay.
Good for him.
And we're back. All right, so... sorry. The distractions. I feel like I kind of need to tell the audience what that last one was.
It's worth it.
Full disclosure, yeah. My son comes out. My son is six. Most of you have probably known that or whatever. And my son is six, and he comes out, and he says that his tummy hurts. And so while I'm trying to ascertain the actual ailment, I notice something under his PJs, and I unzip the top part of his PJs, and he's wearing clothes, full clothes, like long sleeve shirt and a sweater vest and jeans. And I said to my son, why are you wearing clothes? And he says, I don't like it when mommy gets upset with me in the morning because I don't put my clothes on fast enough.
Oh, that's so sweet.
And so we just went and chatted with mommy. And of course we talked and, you know, the simple solution is when mommy comes into your room the first time and says, it's time to get up, you should get up and put your clothes on. That's the easy solution. So that she doesn't have to get upset. And so then the ailment of my tummy hurts turned into my throat hurts. I want a glass of water. So that's where we are now. So he is now getting his water and his mother is tucking him back in. So
he may have just been dehydrated.
Yeah, after having
that many layers of clothes.
Three layers of clothes, plus he sleeps with a personal blanket and then sheets and then the quilt or the blanket, his comforter. And that's what,
jeez. One, three,
four, five. It's like six layers of things he was under. Okay. Anyway, the movie, The Black Panther, 2018's movie, The Black Panther, starring Anderson, South Carolina's own Chadwick Boseman. He went to high school across the street. The high school he went to is across the street from where I lived for the year that I lived in Anderson. Michael B. Jordan, Lupita Nyong'o. I always pronounce it wrong. She won an Oscar along with her roles in whatever she won an Oscar for. 12 Years a Slave, I think she won it for. I can't remember. Mm-hmm. 12 Years a Slave. I forgot she was in The Force Awakens. She's Maz Kanata. I forgot that. Anyway.
Yeah.
So this movie, directed by Ryan Coogler.
Bless you.
When I mentioned earlier, was highly lucrative. The movie had a $200 million budget. You're like, oh my gosh, big Marvel, $200 million budget. It made that the opening weekend. It made $200 million opening weekend. It grossed worldwide $1.3 billion. So if you don't think that Marvel wasn't licking their chops when they bought Marvel, 5 years ago, man, that's why they did it. Disney bought Marvel. What did I say?
Yeah, they knew what they were doing. Oh, they knew what they got.
That paid for Toy Story Land.
Yes, among other things. So... So, yeah, so we actually started to ask Andrew, hey, Andrew, what is this movie? But then your computer froze or something froze. So we were looking
at... Yeah, I don't know what happened.
Yeah, we thought you'd fallen asleep again, so...
No, you would hear snoring.
No, that's true. So regale us with what this is, movie-wise. What is this movie?
When King T'Challa returns to his home nation, the secluded but technologically advanced African nation of Wakanda, he is put to the test as both king of his country and Black Panther, when he is drawn into a conflict that puts the fate of Wakanda and the world at risk. To defeat his enemies and protect his country, the king must rally his allies and unleash the power of the Black Panther.
Okay. Whoa. Yep, right on. That's a long, detailed thing.
Yeah, it was better than the other one.
No, okay. I was wondering. Usually IMDb kind of fails, so that's why I was wondering. So Michael B. Jordan, in case you're like, hey, that guy sounds familiar. He's recently in Creed and Creed 2. But he was also, like seemingly like so many other people who are in the MCU, he was in another comic book movie. He was in that really bad, and I mean really bad, Fantastic Four attempt.
Oh, where people, the saying or the thought is that they made it so bad just to make it bad so that Fantastic Four would go out of whoever's hands it was in.
Well, no.
It really was bad.
It was bad. No, that doesn't make any sense because Fox wanted to keep it, right? And the rights were about to revert back to Disney, Marvel. And so they said, well, we'll make another movie. So they made another movie, which is the same reason why Sony made Amazing Spider-Man 1 and 2, because the rights were about to get kicked back over. Mm-hmm. But those movies aren't awful. This movie was.
Yes.
And Michael B. Jordan played... he was the Flash. Thing. Oh. No, he wasn't Flash. He was the... No, you're right. He was Flame Human On. Torch. He was Human Torch. Yeah, right. He was Flame On. And, I mean, I'm like, he wasn't the worst part. He was bad, but it was all bad. It was a terrible movie. And
wasn't that the one where somebody got drunk and, like, did science?
Yes. Yeah, him and...
Not what it was?
I think so. Like, they solved it by getting a little drunk, whatever, and... A lot of it didn't make any sense, and it was really like and Dr. Doom is like this great, great villain, and they beat him almost like accidentally and in a very strange way, and their powers are weird. It fails. It totally fails as a movie. And what you were thinking about, Sam, was not that they did such a bad movie intentionally to. But because the movie was so bad, Marvel says, you need to let us have it back. And because the way it works is that because when Disney bought Marvel, right, so they bought the Marvel, not just the studios, but the brand Marvel, right? Uh-huh. So that means that Disney owns all of the Marvel publications as well as merchandising. So sure, Sony owns the right to Spider-Man. But Marvel, in the extension Disney, owns the merchandising for that. So whenever when Amazing Spider-Man comes out and they want to do merchandising for the movie, they partner up with Disney and say, hey, for every buck you make, we get 25 cents. And Disney's like, sounds great. Something like that. I'm not sure what the ratio is, but that's kind of how it works, right? So for this movie, Disney says, you know what? We're not only not... going to not we're not only going to not give you I think there's enough nots in that the money for your merchandising, we're not going to merchandise the film at all. So if you think back to that 2017 15 16 whatever it was, I don't remember, failed attempt at a movie, there was no merchandising for the movie at all. Hey, come get the thing action figure or the thing hand I want to smash, whatever the thing is, right? Thing smash, whatever it was, right? Like, there was none of that. And then Disney went the next step and said, not only are we not going to do that, we're actually going to kill the characters in the comic book. There will be no more Fantastic Four comic books until the movie rights come back to Marvel. And so you can't go to the stores now and find a new Fantastic Four comic. They don't exist. It's not until it comes back over to Marvel where they'll start writing them again. So, yes, basically 2015, that movie. So basically, don't piss off Disney. That's what it is. And that movie currently sits at a 4.3 on IMDb, which is a little high, in my opinion.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Anyway, so, but that movie is not this movie. This is the movie, the Black Panther, which is
far better,
which currently sits at a 7.4, which is actually kind of low in my opinion. I thought it'd be a little higher.
Well, it's voter suppression.
Voter suppression. Wow, you just come right out and say it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, you're not. I know this was not the first time for any of us seeing this movie. I know we'd all seen this before. I've seen this movie. I saw it once in the theater and seriously four times since it came out on video and Netflix. I mean, later the week it came out on Netflix, I'm like, hey, I'm going to watch that, even though I own it on Blu-ray and have watched it on Blu-ray. I'm still going to watch it. Because I really like the movie. Now, someone said, was it you, Sam, that came out recently? Someone said, hey, I recently watched Black Panther. I don't see why it's so great. Was that you or is that somebody else I'm thinking of?
I saw it and was, I don't know. The first time I thought it was amazing. You know, but the third act in it really kind of doesn't live up to the first two parts.
Okay.
Especially the final fight between Chihuahua and what's the other guy's name?
Did you just say Chihuahua?
Michael Jordan.
And Michael Jordan.
Killmonger and
Killmonger.
T'Challa. You bastard.
Sorry. And I don't know. It was too CGI for me.
I noticed that, and you know, I didn't notice it, or maybe I was just too enthralled in the theater. Mm-hmm. But as I watched it this time, that fight scene, I thought, man, a lot of that is CGI that I didn't realize it was.
Yeah, and like even not only were the two characters CGI, everything around them was.
Yeah.
So for me, it turned into a video game. You know, cut out a review, call it
too much like Avatar, or
well, even Avatar, it felt grounded, and this didn't. Okay. There was just the what do you call it? Uncanny Valley was certainly here during those scenes for me, and that kind of took me away. In it, but I love the world building they did in the movie. I love the characters and the especially Killmonger's. Motivations are totally make sense. So everything up until that point was amazing. And then that was kind of a letdown. And I think that's why for me,
okay.
It kind of went down in my mind in terms of quality.
Okay. Interesting. The only things that I really, I don't think this is a perfect movie. I think that Marvel has done a better job with some other of his other movies. I mean, even the same year, Thor Ragnarok, I thought is a better film. And I know some people that don't like Thor Ragnarok. Mm-hmm. I've gotten into many arguments with my work colleague / occasional roommate while I do the podcast, Chris. He hates Thor Ragnarok because they turned Thor into he's kind of the class clown kind of a thing as opposed to he says he's a god. I'm like, well, no, he's a dude. Just we think he's a god because they live a long time, but he's mortal. He's a dude. He just his time is different than ours. And he says, yeah, but he's not supposed, he's Thor. He's not supposed to be awkward guy. I'm like, yeah, but I mean, the most badass dudes ever can still be awkward around a hot girl that they like. but anyway, I I do like this movie a lot. I think this movie has a lot of really good moments. It's certainly funny. You know, there's as in most Marvel movies, there's a lot of suspension of belief.
Yeah.
But for me, it's less of the technology of the belief and more of the real world stuff. Like when they capture Kruger and they take him to that safe house, the CIA safe house, like that was the worst safe house I'd ever seen. Right? Like, I feel like the CIA has better security than a couple of nerds with some computers and some bad cameras. He gets shot in the back. And he's and Chitala says, "Well, let us take him." And they're like, "Okay, what? No, he's like an agent in the CIA or a high ranking agent in the CIA. You don't, you know what I'm saying? Like in every other movie that we've ever seen, where there's people are having pissing contests over jurisdiction, like that would never happen. You know what I'm saying? Like that would never happen. Like his like he should have a partner or someone or a supervisor or someone that would come in and go." He can't go anywhere without me. Like, there would be an argument. And maybe they decided not to put it in the movie because it was going to waste too much time. But that seems too easy to take a... You know what I'm saying? That seems too easy. And there's other couple of moments in the movie that I kind of brush aside as just whatever. It's fine, but... anyway, we'll get there. However, this movie does follow my rule that if I don't take a lot of notes, it's because I like the movie. I didn't take very many notes, but that's just because I just get sucked into this movie. The world building of the movie, I like it a lot. So I didn't take many, many notes. But it does have the typical Marvel trope, right? Where his father has to die.
Yeah.
Is there a comic book hero, a Marvel hero with living father? I'm trying to think.
Thor.
His dies in Thor Ragnarok.
He's alive for a while, though.
Yeah.
Okay.
His father's death doesn't cause him to become...
No, but it does trigger him to become the ultimate version of Thor.
Well, that's true.
What else you got?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, they're all, I mean, I guess, because, even, like, your ancillary characters, like, well, your real ancillary characters, like, the Falcon. Like, we don't talk about his parents because we don't, frankly, don't care. Obviously, Captain Rogers' parents are dead because, well, even if they hadn't been dead in the first Captain America movie, they would have died because of old age because, you know, 50 years later. So, but I mean, like, T'Challa's parent, you know, his father is killed, which kind of creates the thing. Peter Parker loses both his parents and then uncle. Tony Stark loses his dad. So, we don't know anything about Bruce Banner's parents. Anyway, just a thing. It's a trope.
Steve Rogers.
That's what I mentioned, Captain America.
Yeah.
His parents are dead, though. He's an orphan. They mentioned that in Cap 2. So, anyway. Nice throw. Oh, yeah. Never mind. It's fine. sorry, I'm going through the few notes that I wrote. Like, one of the things I wrote was nice throw. He jumps out of that plane and just tosses those little balls in the air, and they land perfectly on the car. I just... he could be an NFL quarterback with aim like that. I'm just saying.
Maybe the little balls had magnetic.
Sure. Okay. They're in a jungle. You know, there's not a whole lot of magnet, the metal for them to jump to. So, okay.
I mean, don't they also like show YouTube videos as well?
Yes. Yeah. Those magic balls were pretty universal, right? Like, your phone's ringing. My bracelet's ringing too. Let's just put them together in a hologram form so that they can see both of us. there is a lot of convenient technology in the movie.
A lot of fun technology, and it almost kind of makes me a little mad though, because that same technology can save lots of lives outside of Wakanda.
Yeah, the kidding.
Right?
Yeah, I know.
So, like, I feel a little bit kind of perturbed that they've been hiding all this.
No.
So,
yeah, I kind of get that to a point, but, you know, it's the same thing, right? Like, the reason why they didn't is because if the world found out in, like, the, let's say, the 40s what they could do, then you know how the world would have been. The World War II would have been directed at them.
Yeah.
You know, and so because they were the haves and they are the, we know, like there would have been flying vehicles that would have been flying circles around our fighter planes from World War II and stuff. So I get why they kind of have hidden, but at the same time, it's like the same argument about like the wizarding world of Harry Potter. It's like, well, wait a minute, you guys can just wave a wand and cure global warming and all food problems and water shortages, and yet you guys hide and don't understand how light bulbs work. Like, come on now. So I'm with you. I'm with you to a point.
Yeah. And are I cannot remember. The bumps on Killmonger. Mm-hmm. Isn't that like people he's killed?
Yes.
Yeah, I think that's what he said.
Right?
Yeah.
So yeah. We're led to believe that he's done all of that before even getting to his final phase of getting to Wakanda and taking over.
Well, he used to be a CIA black op. Like Martin Freeman was like, yeah, he was one of ours. And like they would send him in because that's what he did, right? His whole purpose was to get training. To get trained up so that he could then win this fight against, the king.
Yeah.
One of the things that people liked about this movie, and it's what people have always said, is that a Marvel movie is only as good as its villain. And that's what made Infinity War so fantastic, is because, you know...
You can understand Thor... what's his name?
Thanos is, yeah, I mean, it's his hero motivations. Journey. I mean, the movie is about Thanos. It's not about the team. It's about him. It's his movie. And so.
Which is brilliant.
It really
is. I love that they did that.
Yeah, it was truly brilliant. He's not just some faceless, you know, CGI'd bad guy that just shows up that they have to fight, you know. So in this movie, he's totally relatable. You kind of get where he's coming from.
He's one of us in terms of, you know, America and
yeah.
Yeah.
And you kind of get, you know, his dad was killed by his dad. So you kind of get the revenge thing. And frankly, the only reason why he's a bad guy in our eyes as the audience is because he wants to take the weapons to the streets and have uprisings across the world that will kill people.
Mm-hmm.
That's the only reason why he's considered a bad guy. I mean, frankly, otherwise, he's totally right in his quest to gain power in a country that is rightfully his to a point. So,
Chihuahua cheated in terms of losing the fight and then coming back.
Wait, he went out? He
right?
What do you mean?
Chihuahua losing the fight.
He didn't lose the fight, technically. Remember, you either have to be killed or yield, and he did neither.
Mm.
That's why he says, the fight's not over. I'm still here.
Yeah.
And that was one of the reasons why. Now, he kind of have to also be like, man, it would have been a lot better for Infinity War. You guys would have had a better shot if you didn't just have a civil war and had killed a bunch of you know what I'm saying? Like you didn't have to kill a bunch of your own people. But then again, you could also say, hey, Thor, had you not killed your sister? She's like the only being in the galaxy that could kill Thanos. So it's a way to go.
But we still don't know if she would have.
Oh, she absolutely would have. Yeah.
You think so?
Yeah, because he's a threat to her and to Asgard. Remember, she wants to conquer the universe. That includes Thanos.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right.
Yeah. That's why, and that's the big theory, is that's why Thanos waits to attack Thor after she's dead. Because she's the only thing that can truly stop him. And so, anyway.
Interesting.
Yeah.
And because her power came from Asgard itself. Asgard was okay. All
yeah,
right,
that's see. Why
I get.
Yeah, Thanos makes would sense. Have to have destroyed Asgard in order to stop her.
Yeah,
which he kind of technically killed half of Asgard again. Poor Asgard. I mean, that used to be this beacon of whatever, and they're down to like a handful of people. So. I did always kind of wonder what was Hulk doing during the attack? The attack comes, Thor's beat up, Loki's there, and then Hulk is like hiding long enough for Loki to talk for a little bit and then say we have a Hulk, and then Hulk comes out of nowhere. Like, hey Banner, come over here.
Maybe the Hulk really, really likes a good entrance.
Yeah,
like, I mean, you know, when he fights Thor in Ragnarok, you know, he has a pretty good entrance.
That's true. Mm-hmm.
Maybe that's his thing. He's kind of like a prima donna in the green room.
Yeah, yeah. He's off in the. He's like in the bathroom, like psyching himself up. Like Hulk can beat that.
Smash!
Oh, he said my name. We have a Hulk. Time to go. Ah!
Oh, sure. See, this is what we need. Corny to be like, guys.
Yeah.
Oh.
Anyway, another thing that kind of annoyed me in the movie was the heist. So.
The museum heist?
Yeah. So I'm great with the heist until they fake the part that they come in as paramedics.
Yeah.
And then they shoot the bad guys, right? Now I know that they're looping the cameras, but they still find out that it's them anyway, somehow. Maybe security cameras, I don't know. It seems strange to, because he says the line, and I'll play it later, I actually captured it. Like, we want to make it look like amateurs, but, like, they found out it was you anyway. It seems strange. Like, it seemed a lot of effort for a lot of subterfuge for no reason. But, I don't know, whatever, it's fine. Say there was something else that kind of annoyed me about the movie, and I can't remember it. I did laugh out loud both this time and in the theater when they're having the big fight at the end, the big civil war, and the rhino comes charging in, and she just steps in front of her friend, and the rhino stops and licks her. Because there's only so much animal instinct, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, this animal is built to kill, except her, because that's his buddy. You know, I just thought that was great. That made me laugh. I also liked the gorilla, the guy that played the gorilla, the King M'Baku. I liked his accent. Wait, whenever he talked, I just liked him. What?
And didn't they when they were filming Infinity War, they didn't realize.
Did you just go pew pew? It sounded like you just went pew pew. Sorry, what were you saying? When they were filming Infinity War?
Infinity War, when his people came out, they were doing their chant.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And they kept it, but they had no idea where it came from.
Yeah.
They hadn't even seen the movie.
Yeah, basically, like, to psych up the... Because they used the same extras. It was the exact same extras, the same army of people of extras. So when they're out there in the field getting ready to get psyched up, the guy, the leader, does that, whoo, and they'll go, ah, whatever they do, right? Whatever the call and answer is. And the director's like, wait, what is that? And they go, oh, we learned that on set of Black Panther. And he's like, oh, I didn't know you guys did that. That's cool. Let's do it in the movie. And so they did.
I did laugh out loud with M'Baku when they went to ask him for help. And they're talking to the CIA guy. And then he's like, I'm in. And then M'Baku says, are you done? Are you leaving yet? Or something like that.
Yeah. It's like, are you guys done? Please leave. This whole moment where they're like, it's funny how Marvel movies make fun of that moment.
You know, they find brevity in.
Yes.
And levity, sorry.
Yeah.
And that's what makes them so good.
Like, they did it. You know, my favorite was in Guardians of the Galaxy, right? Where Peter Quill's like, I need your help. And he's like, then one of them stands up and says, I'm with you. And then the other one stands up. And then they all stand up. And then finally Rocket's like, all right, fine, I'm with you. We're all standing. We're all standing in a circle like a bunch of assholes. love that beat. I love that part.
So, you know, and I think the reason that it makes it so much better is because that's how that's how we are in every day, at least my circle of people around. You know, we'll be serious for a minute, but then we kind of break off and make fun of each other or whatever.
Yeah, you need the moment, right? Like you've had your hero moment. Now it's, you know, I mean, even Daredevil, not Daredevil. I mean, I know the whole movie of Deadpool, and the whole movie is this, but like, they're getting ready to do the face off, and he goes, she's going to do the hero landing. She's going to do the hero landing. And then she does the hero landing. He goes like, oh, it's so bad on your knees. I still need to see the second one.
Yeah, it's pretty good. It's really good. I'm probably going to go see the PG-13 version this Christmas because I just have to see what they do.
Wait, what's that? What? PG-13?
Have you not heard of this?
No.
Oh. You haven't heard of this? There was a trailer.
I've been in media blackout for the last 4 days.
Just for Christmas, there's a Deadpool PG-13 version being released.
Really?
Dead serious. And he does the trailer with Fred Savage.
I have seen that. Oh, my God. I didn't watch it like with audio, but I saw it somewhere.
Yeah, I'm trying to find the link now. Once Upon a Deadpool.
Oh, my gosh.
So,
Once Upon a Deadpool.
But apparently they've added some scenes and with Fred Savage. So I just like, now I've got to go see what the heck he's going to do with this.
Oh, my gosh. Deadpool 2.
So. Yeah.
Oh, it's weird. It's not showing up on his IMDb credits.
Here you go. I'm sent the link in Google chat thing here.
Oh, shoot. Where'd it go? There it is.
So I don't know if you want to pause the podcast, go watch it.
No. Well, no. What? No, that's. I'll watch it later. I'll have it pulled up. Oh, I said later. Gracious.
If you had dozed off. Welcome back.
Yeah. If you were using this podcast to fall asleep to, sorry. It's not showing up as a thing. Deadpool 2, Honest Trailers as Deadpool, Pokemon Detective Pikachu, Six Underground, The Croods 2, The Hitman's Wife's Bodyguard. That's hysterical. I love The Hitman's Bodyguard. And then Deadpool 3. He's doing a movie called Clue. He's doing Clue based on the board game. Yeah, they're doing a Clue. Oh, he's the only person to cast. I was going to say, I wonder if it's got Sam's buddy in there, Tim Curry.
Yeah.
Getting wild with Deadpool 2. My gosh. All right. Well, that's great. I'll check that out. Anyway,
what were we talking about?
I don't know. We were just making fun of brevity and stuff in the movie.
Piss off, Ghost.
Piss off, Ghost.
I laugh out loud every time.
He's freaking gone.
He kicks the wall.
And he kicks the wall. That character's the best. And again, my buddy, he hated that part too because he's like, that character is supposed to be like this huge, stoic, awesome kind of character. And they turned him into a punchline. And I'm like, yeah, I guess it depends. Because some people also got mad at the Mandarin, and they turned him into
Trevor. See, I thought that was a brilliant twist. Trevor. I love that. I love that twist.
It's because you and I never read the comics.
Yeah.
Like, we don't care. Like, we don't have anything beholden to the fact that the Mandarin is a magic user, which at the time, we didn't have magic users. Doctor Strange was the first real magic user we had. And so I didn't think it would play well, Iron Man versus a magic dude. You know what I'm saying? Like, it would have been weird. Now, and then we get Doctor Strange, and then even in Doctor Strange, they kind of explain it in a better way than just, he's just magic. He has rings that produce magic. But then again, then we see Thanos that has stones that can produce magic. So I guess whatever. I don't know. Trevor Slattery. I'm an actor. anyway. I'm looking in the trivia. Some of the trivia is really strange, but
I'm going to start going through some of these movies' trivias on IMDb and writing in there. Cheapseat Reviews did this.
Nice. I mean, like,
rewrite some of the bad ones.
Oh,
or just add trivia. Cheapseat Reviews did this.
I see. I see what you're saying. This was also, that's right. We saw that where it was like, this movie was reviewed by such and such. .org or something like that. I remember seeing that. So you just want to say, was reviewed by Cheap Seat Reviews.
Yeah.
In November of 2018. Okay.
Sure.
I like
Why not?
I like that idea. What? Oh, whatever. That was a dumb one.
Okay.
Stanley. I was looking at the. So I guess actually we should say this, or I should say this. The one of the reasons why we chose this movie was as a way of typically whenever we watch, whenever an actor or director or someone of note has passed away, we like to do their movie as a way of kind of, you know, remembering them.
Homage.
Homage, if you will. And that's what this is. We know Stanley has just recently passed away within the last 2 weeks. And he'll greatly be missed. And his role in the Marvel, universe is insane. And I know there's a lot of people that have strong feelings for and against Stan Lee and what he did to some other people. And I'm not going to get into all that. A lot of it I don't know or even understand. So all I'm just going to say is thank you, Stan Lee, for what you gave us. You gave us some really cool characters, this being one of them.
We've had a lot of fun with.
And of course, I give him credit for Spider-Man, which is my favorite of the Marvel world. Spider-Man. The Spider-Man is my favorite. Which one's yours? I guess I actually asked Twitter and Facebook which ones were their favorite Stan Lee characters. What are yours, gentlemen?
Oh,
well, I mean,
I've never really thought about.
I guess probably before this whole MCU came along, I've been a fan of X-Men.
Wolverine.
Wolverine is definitely
sure
one of my favorites. But of the new stuff, Is Deadpool a Stan Lee character?
No.
No? Okay. Well, then never mind.
I don't think so.
That I'm talking.
I can look it up, but I don't think so.
I could always relate to Spider-Man. So I think X-Men I liked because there were so many different powers, so many different people, some neat things, interesting ideas. But in terms of a singular superhero, I would have to go with Spider-Man as well.
Okay.
Yeah, he's got a lot of characters I'm looking at here. A lot that I don't know, and I'm sure we'll see in Captain Marvel. But did Mar-Vell, I guess, before that? Mm-hmm. And then things like Swamp Thing and Adam Warlock, characters that we haven't really seen a lot yet.
Yeah. I'm looking at the characters created by Stan Lee on the Wikipedia. It's a bunch. Really? He created that many? Oh my gosh. So I guess, it's not just the fact that it's, what? It's not just that it's the hero, he also created the villains that the hero had to create or had to fight, so it's not just the fact that he created Spider-Man. Mm-hmm. He also had to create Doc Ock and Electro and whatever. So yeah, my gosh, it's so many. Absorbing Man. What is Absorbing Man? Oh my gosh.
He absorbs things. It's kind of like the Bounty, quicker picker upper.
He could take the form of any material he touched, absorbing the property. Both the power worked for and against him, such as being turned into water, then mixed with dirt to become mud. He was once became cocaine and had to reassemble himself. Oh my gosh. This is terrifying and awful at the same time. Ego, the living planet. Oh yeah, Ego. He fought Ego in Guardians of the Galaxy. Anyway, oh, there you go.
So, sorry.
Yeah, so good job, sir. May you ever find peace. So there you go. So back to the review of the thing. I was looking actually to see what people posted because I asked what people said, and I'm trying to find my post, and I can't find it. Hey, what's everyone's... someone wrote... My friend wrote... Professor X, Black Widow, Groot, and Chris Evans.
I'm like, I saw that. I thought that was great.
Yeah, I was like, I like how you're giving credit to the fact that he invented a human.
Did you see the new trailer for the Lego movie?
I did not.
There's a part where the character, what's his name?
The hero?
The hero.
Yeah.
It meets, can't even remember the name of it, but he's a dinosaur wrangler, archaeologist, space hero. Like, he goes through this whole list of things that he does.
He actually gets to meet.
It's all the characters that
Chris Pratt
gets to do. Or Chris Pratt, yeah.
That's funny.
Chris Pratt gets to do.
That's funny. Oh, I love it. I love it, I love it, I love it. Okay, so I was looking to see what else Chadwick Boseman has done. He's done a bunch of TV before he got to do... He did 42, he was Jackie Robinson, and then kind of after that, he was on a draft day, Gods of Egypt. I didn't know what is that?
Oh, poor thing. You don't want to know. That's where they whitewashed Egypt, basically, remember?
Oh, yeah, I didn't see that one. Probably for good reason. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. That had the guy from the Game of Thrones in there, didn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
And then
Walter Costa living guy.
And then he goes into Captain America. Then he jumps into his Marvel stuff. He does Captain America Civil War, Message from the King, Marshall, Black Panther, Infinity War. Untitled Infinity War or Avengers movie post-production. That's the one next year. And he's doing something coming up called 17 Bridges. Follows a disgraced detective in the NYPD who was given a shot at redemption. Thrust into a citywide manhunt for a cop killer. Okay. Well, neat. Taylor Kitsch, Sienna Miller. Ooh. J.K. Simmons. Keith David. I always like a good movie with Keith David. Okay, cool. There you go. There's a movie. Anyway, you ready for some Clippy Clips?
Let's do it.
Oh, gosh. You scared me. Great. I didn't actually capture a lot, honestly, because there's a lot of fight scenes and action scenes that kind of go through the movie, and there's just not a lot of moments to get it. But, yeah. There we go. Number one.
Hey, come here. Come here. Come here. It's okay. You can go, but just don't tell anyone, all right?
Bro, why you ain't just shoot him right here?
Because it's better to leave the crime scene more spread out.
Makes us look like amateurs.
Okay. So Andy Serkis, we need to talk about him for just a second. He is a treasure.
Yep.
So he's... Here's my legit question to you, gentlemen. Because if you look at his IMDb listing, right? Typically, we don't see his face on camera. We just don't. Mm-hmm. Like, look at the movies he's known for. When you look for known for, the first three are as Caesar in the Planet of the Apes trilogy, the new one.
Which is amazing.
And I've only seen one and two. I haven't seen the third one yet. But the acting in that, as that character, is really great. He's also Gollum, right, in the Lord of the Rings trilogy. He was Snoke in The Last Jedi. and a whole bunch of other stuff.
That's a CGI character.
He's great as everything that he's CGI in. I mean, he's done a bunch of other stuff. He's done stuff where his face is on. I mean, like one of his more random movies where he was on camera was in 13 going on 30. I mean, he's like an executive.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that.
Yeah, but I mean, he's great. And so my question is, when will there be, and it won't, and I'm saying it's going to be him, but it should be him, but I'm not saying it's going to be. But when will the Academy nominate someone for a mocap as best actor? You know what I'm saying? Like,
question.
When will we get that? Because it can't be animated. Not an animated movie. I'm talking about emotion.
Was Gollum supporting? Did he not get anything for supporting in that?
They might have gotten CGI. Best CGI. Let me
see. Oh, yeah.
He's been nominated for a bunch of stuff. So let's go here. He's nominated. He's won a whole bunch of, or he's been nominated for a bunch of Academy of Science Fiction and Fantasy Horror films. He was nominated for a Saturn Award for Best Actor in Planet of the Apes, Best Actor for Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, won for Rise of the Planet of the Apes, nominated for Return of the King, and won for The Two Towers. But as far as the Academy goes, the actual Academy, I'm looking. Again, he's won so many. His list is insane. Because it's from all these different stuff. No, he's not been nominated for the Academy of Motion Pictures, whatever it's called. Nothing. No. He's won 38 things and 52 nominations, but not the Academy Awards. So that's kind of the same. That's my question is, will the Academy ever do it or come up with, if there's enough movies where we're doing motion capture, have a best motion capture category?
I mean, there's more and more every year. So,
yeah.
Stuff like the new Avatar coming out. I mean, every one of the Star Wars movies, the recent ones, Star Wars stories, I guess I could say.
Everything has motion capture. I mean, everything. Yeah. It's insane. Oh, I did see a really funny thing, by the way. Speaking of new movies and motion capture. The new Lion King trailer posted this weekend, right?
Yeah.
And a buddy of mine posted this really great meme. And so it's like, oh, so the new Lion King, that live action movie. And he goes, but aren't the animals CGI? Yes. And the terrain is CGI. Yeah. And the background is CGI. Yeah. So it's an animated movie. No, it's live action. Because at least in the Jungle Book, there was a human. You know what I'm saying? The Jungle Book movie had a human that had to act and interact with other things, real things. But none of this is real. It's all of it CGI. So, but it's still Jon Favreau, and I'm going to go watch it. So,
anyway. Yeah, it'll be good.
Yes, it will be. Okay, here we go. That was my first clip. Second clip. You know your movie is cool when you can put a meme in the movie.
And what are these?
The real question is
cool. I just like hearing him talk, so I captured more of this.
Well, that is quite the entourage. You got a mixtape coming out?
Oh, yeah. Actually, there is one. Yeah, I'll send you the SoundCloud link if you like. Hey, Dave, can you get the link to
Please, don't make me listen to your music. I just meant you got a lot of people with you.
Don't make me listen to your music. The last one I got, again, was great. 28 seconds, though it has a funny punchline. It's a contradiction, but we'll get there.
Well, Your Highness, the new king is a U.S. The new king...
You cannot talk! One more word, and I will feed you to my children.
I'm kidding. We have vegetarians.
That was a great line. But if they're vegetarians, then how did they find King Chitala down by the river while the guy was fishing?
Oh.
Yeah. Okay. Whatever. It's fine.
Maybe he was fishing for kelp.
Maybe. I mean, maybe they're the kind of vegetarians that also eat fish and chicken, you know?
Yeah.
So, or maybe just fish. Episcopalians. Not Episcopalians. What do they call it? Piscatarian. Episcopalian. He's created a religion. Okay. Here we go.
And now for some more bad news. Ready?
You know, there's Episcopalians. In response for being asked what it felt like to being one of the only few non-black actors on set, and sometimes the only non-black actor on set, Martin Freeman said, "You know, right, this is what black actors feel like all the time." The Black Panther was created July of 1966, 2 months before the founding of the Black Panther Party. Many people mistakenly accused the name referred to the party, so the character was renamed to the Black Leopard. However, neither the readers or the creators cared for the title, and it didn't last long. And I remember when this movie was coming out, and people that didn't know anything about it were like, I can't believe you're going to go watch a movie about the Black Panther Party and its rise to power. Like, that's not what this is about.
I'm sorry, y'all.
Interrupted your Black Panther Party.
Yeah, I love that scene.
Exactly.
And we go to the same place at the same time.
Yep.
Yeah, that's one of my favorite moments from that movie. Director Ryan Coogler describes Zuri as the Wakandan Obi-Wan Kenobi. So, there you go.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah, why not? No scenes were filmed in Africa. All Wakanda scenes were filmed in Georgia. The Korean scenes were shot in Korea. Yeah.
Georgia, so, the state of Georgia or the country of Georgia?
The state of Georgia.
So I'm guessing some of those rolling hills were Appalachian Blue Ridge Mountains?
Or CGI, but yes.
Wow.
Yeah, Georgia, like basically Marvel, once Georgia said, hey, North Carolina, since you're going to screw yourselves with getting rid of your film incentives, we'll take all of your film down here in Georgia. And so since then, they filmed almost all of the, pretty much since about Captain America 3 on, has been there. A lot of it's been there, which is frustrating.
Yeah.
The Royal Talon remote pilot system is voiced by South African comedian Trevor Noah. I thought that was kind of cool. Because I like Trevor Noah.
Trevor.
He makes me laugh. All right. That's it. That's what do we do here? Well, I go down here to this. And press I play button. This.
Excuse me while I whip this out.
So we think we've done a top three before, this top three before, but then again, the movie we would have done for never made it to posting.
Well, we also did Congo.
We also did do Congo, and I don't remember what we did our top three for, and it's not written down on my sheet anywhere.
Yeah.
So I have no way of knowing. So we're not going to know. So
we'll just do it again. We'll fix it in post.
We'll fix it in post. So anyway, we're doing movies set in Africa. And if you're listening and you go, I just listened to that Congo episode last week and you did do that, let us know. But otherwise we're just going to do it again. So,
we're a little lazy after eating all the turkey.
Yeah. In fact, you people should be thankful. I said thankful that we're even doing an episode the week of Thanksgiving.
I'm just all saying. Two of you.
Yes, I'm just saying.
Well, probably one who's still listening by now.
Yeah.
Okay, maybe. Okay, yeah, it's only about one. Anyway.
The other one just downloaded us for a pity download.
Yeah, you're not wrong.
After that.
You're not wrong. So anyway, wow, weird. Apparently people liked the Shining episode, but not so much The Last Castle. I guess if people would email us and let us know what they wanted us to do, we'd get more downloads. out. We got a download last week from Japan. That's cool.
Awesome.
That's really cool.
Konnichiwa, Ohio.
Konnichiwa, right. Ohio. Did you go there this week?
Had a listener in Japan.
Yeah, you just saying, just offended him. He offended most of the world with his accent.
Ohio is, I believe, it's hello.
It's also a state.
It's a state in the Union. I'm not sure what you're trying to say, but okay. Konnichiwa? Is that what you're trying to say?
That is. What is Konnichiwa?
I don't know. I don't know.
Tokyo.
Yeah, Tokyo. There you go. You can say that.
Yeah.
Sushi. Yeah. There you go. All right.
Do you know they don't eat sushi with chopsticks over there? They use their hands.
Use your fingers, yeah, like you're supposed to.
We, Americans, we've ruined that too.
Yeah, like we ruined a lot of things.
Yep.
But not movies. We make good movies. I didn't know this was a quick one. That's weird. Okay, Andrew, your movie's set in Africa. Obviously not filmed because this movie wasn't filmed in Africa. But
right, yeah. Well, this one, I'm going to say it's my number three, even though it may not really count because it was technically filmed off the coast of Africa in the Indian Ocean. But African pirates, I guess.
Oh, were Captain Phillips.
Captain Phillips, yeah. So that would be number three.
Okay.
Number two, Raiders of the Lost Ark was set in Egypt.
Okay.
And then number one, Coming to America.
Nice.
Okay.
Right. Okay. I thought it was.
I'll allow it. I mean, yeah.
Well,
I mean, it's a made up country, but it's supposed to be in Africa.
As opposed to Wakanda.
Right.
Did you see that thing on Facebook that's been floating around where a person was having to do
a presentation
and they did the whole thing in Wakanda and the teacher was like, yep, that sounds great. Like, how can you not know that that's not a real place?
Oh, I love it.
Of course,
we're teaching our children.
Of course, then again, I didn't know that Central Africa.
I would totally give that student an A. I think it's awesome.
Yeah, no, I'm with you.
Creative.
Sam.
All right. My choices. I've got Beasts of No Nation, a Netflix film,
which is on our list to do.
Yep. I've got a Hotel Rwanda.
Okay.
And to round out my depressing, African film session here. My number one is Last King of Scotland.
All right.
And I had to think to myself: Is there a good, not a good movie, but is there a pleasant movie that comes out of Africa?
Sure. I'm going to name some.
Okay.
I wrote down 1, 2, 3, 4. I did 5 movies because I just assumed that.
There was a lot, yeah.
That you guys were going to copy some of the ones that I wrote. So I didn't. That's why I wrote 5 in case I needed to flip any out, but you didn't.
Oh, nice.
I was actually surprised. So my number 5, I wrote Congo because it's fun as hell. I don't care. actually, I have 6 movies. I lied. I have 6 movies.
My I like to chop gorillas in half with a laser, too.
Well, yeah, you know, it's good hunting on the weekend. Sahara would be my number 5.
Okay. Oh, I forgot about Sahara. That is a fun movie.
It's a fun movie. It's dumb. It's not a good movie, but it's fun as hell. Lord of War, your Nicolas Cage.
Yeah.
I've been trying to, try to put that on the podcast on the to-do list for some time, but it just never freaking streams.
There's a movie called War Dogs that I watched. I think it might even be on Netflix. Might be something to check out. Okay. Jonah Hill it's basically Lord of War with Jonah Hill and another kid and a true story.
Cool. Yeah, I did see that or saw that it existed. I didn't watch it, but my number something, whatever my next number is Lion King. You know, there's something you're happy.
Yeah.
My 2 was District 9.
Yep.
I actually liked
District 9. That's a really happy one.
I didn't say that we're all going to be happy. Oh, it's streaming on the Amazon Prime. Oh. Look at that. Your Lord of War. It's going on the list.
There you go.
Somewhere. We have lots of movies that are just kind of on the list. And my number uno I have as Ghost and the Darkness.
Yep. Which apparently we did and then didn't post.
Yeah, we did record it. I know we recorded it, but I think...
And this was pre-Andrew, wasn't it? This was Chad.
Oh, this was like episode 8 or something.
Yeah.
This was super early, but I remember doing it. It was early enough that I remember actually recording audio for it. Like, we were capturing clips. Like, one of the first movies I did clips for. Because, like, the first 5 or 6 movies I didn't do audio clips for. And so... But something happened to it. Something... I had a malfunction in my computer and it dumped the whole thing, or I don't remember what it was, but we don't, I don't have it anymore. So, anyway, we might do that one again as a podcast. I think that'd be a lot of fun. So anyway,
I've actually seen the two lions at the Chicago Museum.
Really? I think,
yep.
I think you said that actually when we did it. So
yep.
That's actually,
they're not as big as you think they would be.
Well, they're lion. I mean, they're not. Oh, no, lions aren't all that big, are they?
No, they're basically, if you would think of a Great Dane, about the size of a Great Dane.
Oh, neat. No, that's still terrifying.
Yeah.
Because they could still eat you.
Yes.
Okay, great.
Yeah, okay.
That's our show. It was a little helter-skelter, but again, we did just all eat a whole bunch of turkey and stuff, so.
Yeah.
Next week we're doing something fun. I don't know what it is. I can't think of what it's supposed to be. This is what's supposed to happen. This is where you guys give me your out of 10.
Oh yeah.
Thanks. Thanks, Harry Potter, for reminding me what we're supposed to be doing. This is Andrew. You give me your number, sir.
Yeah. So I love the movie. I think it's well done. There were some things, like I said, this time that I noticed that I didn't see in the film. Or didn't notice in the film when I watched it in the theater, which may drop it a couple of points for me, but it's still up there with a 7.89.
Okay, great. Sam?
Like any Marvel film lately, you just have to be pretty bad to get below a 7. And I'd say about a 7.5 for me. I think it was a decent Marvel film. Not my favorite, but I'd put it a good middle of the field of all the Marvel films for me.
Okay. Yeah, there's been a bunch of them. There's been like 19 of them now, right? Or something like that.
Yep.
So I think when I did my Marvel list not that long ago, it was in the top half.
Yeah.
For me. I think. I can't remember, honestly. Yeah, so it's probably somewhere around there. So I'm kind of with you guys. I'm going to split your difference and do a 7.69. Not quite the difference, but whatever. Good movie. It's a lot of fun. I enjoy it. It's a good time. It still kind of makes me sad, though, that so many people had to die in their little civil war. Would have been real handy a few months later.
The six-armed people or whatever they were.
Yeah, the space dogs.
Space dogs.
And I did like...
Space dogs!
Watch out! I did like the end, of course, where Bucky Barnes is there and they call him the White Wolf.
And, yes. So, come help Chihuahua, White Wolf.
Yeah. I seriously want you guys to just blast Sam on Twitter for calling Chitala Chihuahua. Just, you should do that. Feel free. Next week, we're doing a movie that's a little different called Extinction.
Oh.
Called what?
Nothing.
Okay. It's called Extinction. It's a Netflix original, and
doesn't it Michael Pena?
Michael Pena, yep, he's in this. And Extinction, I spelled Extinction wrong. How do you spell Extinction? Jeez.
Extinction.
I did so bad at that.
Extinction.
I added a J in there somehow. I keep getting extension. I keep writing like extension cord. What is wrong with me? I don't know. Anyway, we're doing Extinction next week.
Woo-hoo.
And don't know why. I just saw it. It looked fun, so I'm doing it.
Sure.
Yeah. It keeps coming up with cruel intentions. I don't know why. It's kind of pissing me off a little bit here. Anyway, it's fine. I can't type clearly. There it is. Oh, yeah. So yeah, it's got your Michael Pena and your Lizzie Chaplin, and it's got a 5.8 on IMDb. So I don't know. We'll see. But yeah. In the meantime, we are going to do the end of the show here, where I say things like you can follow us on Facebook.com/CheapSeatReviews. Send us your emails. If you have a movie you want us to do, let us know, either through the email, Twitter, or the Facebook. It's the easiest way to get a hold of us. Someone has already requested that we do the new Christmas Chronicles, that new...
with Jeff Bridges.
Actually.
It's with... Kurt Russell.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah, that's what I meant.
Yeah, that other bearded guy.
Yeah.
Old white guys with beard just confuse the hell out of Sam. It's fine. So, but yeah, we're doing that in the month of December, obviously, for that. And, we'll be doing next week is that movie I just said, Extinction. And then after that, it will be, we're doing a World War II movie kind of in celebration, or not celebration, it's the wrong word, but in honor, in memoriam of the I can't think, whatever the math is, anniversary of the bombing of Pearl Harbor. I'll have that next week, I promise.
I'll see.
So that'll be that. And it's, and I think one of the last few good Nicolas Cage movies. But will it hold up? I guess we'll find out in 2 weeks. But next week, Extinction. But that's going to do it for us. You may follow us on Twitter at CheapSeatCast, and CheapSeatReviews@gmail.com, of course, is the website or the email address. So, yeah, so on behalf of Andrew and Sam, this is Sean saying thank you so much for listening, and we'll see you next week.
Chihuahua.